fall down prostrate. You are the only one worthy of praise. I stand before you with an attentive heart. Erase my sins from the present and past. To you I pray, bow down prostrate. You are the only one worthy of praise. I stand before you with an attentive heart. Erase my sins.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to another episode of Lessons from the Quran. Today we're going to talk about a very powerful part of the Quran that has an immense effect upon a person when they read it, and an immense effect in removing a person's problems and a person's sadness. Today we're going to be reading from Surah Al-Anbiya, the 21st Surah of the Quran, from ayah number 83. After saying, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. وأيوب إذ نادى ربه أني مسني الضر وأنت أرحم الراحمين فاستجبنا له فكشفنا ما به من ضر وآتيناه أهله ومثلهم معهم رحمة من عندنا وذكرى للعابدين وإسماعيل وإدريس وذا الكفل كل من الصابرين وأدخلناهم في رحمتنا إنهم من الصالحين وذا النون إذ ذهب مغاضبا فظن أن لن نقدر عليه فنادى في الظلمات أن لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين فاستجبنا له ونجيناه من الغم وكذلك ننجي المؤمنين وزكريا إذ نادى ربه رب لا تذرني فردا وأنت خير الوارثين فاستجبنا له ووهبنا له يحيى وأصلحنا له زوجه إنهم كانوا يسارعون في الخيرات ويدعوننا رغبا ورهبا وكانوا لنا خاشعين والتي أحصنت فرجها فنفخنا فيها من روحنا وجعلناها وابنها آية للعالمين إن هذه أمتكم أمة واحدة وأنا ربكم فاعبدون.
Ayyub, who was afflicted with an affliction that wallahi none of us could bear. And there's no doubt that Allah Azza wa Jal tests the people according to the level of their iman, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. The people who had the greatest test were the prophets, and then the pious people after them according to their iman, all the way down to the person who is tested the least because of the weakness of their iman. And Allah Azza wa Jal would test a person until they walk on the earth with no sins at all because of the amount of trials and tribulations that they've suffered. Ayyub was afflicted with a sickness, and it was so bad that he lost his family and he lost everyone around him. Now you imagine in that circumstance, you've become ill. Not only have you become ill, but you've become ill in a way that means that you've lost your family have gone from you. You're living an isolated life with a contagious disease that you don't have a cure for. Everything in this world that was important to you after the worship of Allah Azza wa Jal, you've lost. Look at the dua of Ayyub. أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرِّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. A calamity, a hardship has afflicted me. Something has afflicted me. Harm has afflicted me. But you, O Allah, أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ, the most merciful of those who show mercy. One dua. أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرِّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. One dua. And Allah Azza wa Jal says, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ, we answered his dua. فَكَشَفْنَا مَا بِهِ مِنْ دُرِّ وَآتَيْنَاهُ أَهْلَهُ وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ رَحْمَةً مِنْ عِنْدِنَا وَذِكْرَى لِلْعَابِدِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jal answered him. Not only did Allah Azza wa Jal answer him, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed all of the harm that was on him, all of the sickness and all of the illness. And not only did Allah Azza wa Jal remove the sickness and the illness, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him his family and increased him his family as a mercy from Allah and a reminder for the worshippers. What a beautiful mercy from Allah, and what an amazing reminder for us. Whatever difficulty you're in, whatever situation you're in, however bad your sickness is, and I deal with people generally who are afflicted with black magic, with sihr, with jinn possession, with ayn, with nazar, the evil eye. And I've seen some people that are horrendously afflicted. And as much as I remember, I advise them to make the dua of Ayyub. Because your affliction is not going to reach like Ayyub. This isn't regular leprosy. This is a prophet from the prophets of Allah. If the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his fever that he suffered would have killed an ordinary man. They suffer more. The Prophet suffered far more. He suffered an illness that's not like any of the people who suffered that illness after him. Every ordinary human being would have died. Because this is how Allah tests the prophets, with something that is far, far stronger than what he tests the ordinary people with. Look at Ayyub, what he did. Did he go to a doctor? Did he go to try and find medicine? There was nothing available to him. The Prophet ﷺ commanded us to go and seek a cure. Find medicine if you can. But look at his iman, that his first thing and his first port of call is what? He calls out to his Lord. He says, أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. And I've talked in a previous series on Peace TV about dua. One of the points of tawassul in dua, or coming near to Allah in dua, is to make dua and to mention the state that you're in. Say, oh Allah, sickness has befallen me. Oh Allah, trouble has happened to me. Oh Allah, difficulty has struck me. And you are the most merciful of those who show mercy. And not only did Allah Azza wa Jal answer him, as we said, and remove the illness from him, but he gave him back his family. And then again, because inna ma'al usri yusra, inna ma'al usri yusra. With difficulty comes ease, with difficulty comes ease. Brothers and sisters, there will be people at home watching this who are suffering, wallahi, who are suffering. Suffering in their lives, suffering in their families. Make the dua of Ayyub. Don't delay it till after the program. Don't delay it until 5 minutes time. Sit and make the dua of Ayyub, أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرِّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. Ayah number 83 from Surah Al-Anbiya, the 21st surah in the Mus'haf, in the Qur'an. Read, وَأَيُّوبَ إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرِّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. Believe that Allah Azza wa Jal will answer you. Inshallah, you will not find long passes before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees a cure for you, inshallah ta'ala. And then Allah Azza wa Jal mentions this as a reminder, and He mentions Ismail, and He mentions Idris and Dhul-Kifl, who is known as Isaiah in the Christian scriptures, and all of them were from As-Sabirin, because sabr and patience is one of the characteristics of the prophets. And we entered them into our mercy, and indeed they were from the righteous. After the break, we're going to listen to another prophet who found himself in incredible difficulty, the Prophet Yunus alayhi salam, and the dua that he made, the greatest dua of forgiveness, this dua that he made for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him. That's coming after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Most countries of the world ban bullying. They fight it in their schools and universities. A lot of us are being bullied differently every single day. Some come up to us and say, do this, while others say, don't you dare. Some say this is halal, halal, while others say, nope, this is haram. Haram. Are you confused? Are you confused? Do you feel lost? Join me in Umdatul Ahkam, where, with the grace of Allah, we will learn the proper knowledge from the Qur'an and from the Sunnah, which would help stop this kind of bullying.
Join Asim Al-Hakim in Umdatul Ahkam tonight at 11:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 6 a.m. UK on Peace TV. He faces...
My question is about
he listens.
My question is about the beard, about Imam Mahdi.
What are the people believing?
He answers.
So number one is the help of Allah.
He satisfies in the light of glorious Quran and authentic hadith.
If Allah helps you, believe me, you have to get success.
Catch Dr. Zakir.
Then we have the next call, please.
To get convincing and valid answers in Dial Dr. Zakir every Thursday at 6:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 9:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV.
Where truth is hidden, misleading quotations create confusion. Where truth is hidden, lack of knowledge and wisdom cause upheaval and commotion. Where truth is hidden, manipulated scriptures and twisted facts emerge. This very hidden truth creates false propaganda, mayhem, chaos, disorder, and turmoil in our lives and the world order. But is there anyone with courage and wisdom? What is the truth, and who has the courage to expose it? Because it's your right to know the truth.
Watch Truth Prevail and Lies Perish in Truth Exposed by Dr. Zakir Naik, next on Peace TV.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brothers and sisters. This is the second part of the episode, the dua of the prophets. Surah Al-Anbiya, the 21st surah of the Quran, starting from ayah number 83. We've heard about Ayyub and those other prophets. It's a mercy for us. No matter what good deeds you do, your good deeds do not entitle you to demand paradise from Allah. All you do is work for Allah's mercy, and Allah's mercy is the reason you enter into paradise. وَذَنُّونِ إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا. As for Yunus, who is known as Dhunnun, one of the person associated with the fish or associated with a whale, of course they say that it's a whale in Christian scriptures. In Arabic it says An-Nun or Al-Hut. He's also called Sahib Al-Hut. And Allah Azza wa Jalla knows best. It has to be a pretty big sea animal to swallow a human being. So was it a whale? Was it a different kind of fish? Allah Azza wa Jalla knows best. He left in a state of anger. And that's because he remained patient, calling his people to Islam. And he called them and called them and called them, and they didn't answer. And he became despondent. He became tired, feeling that his ummah was going to be like the ummah of the prophets that came before who didn't answer. I mean, the Prophet ﷺ said there will come a prophet who has one or two people with them, and there will come a prophet on the day of judgment that has nobody with them at all. But Allah Azza wa Jalla had not commanded him to stop calling his people to Islam. Allah Azza wa Jalla had not commanded him to do that. And he turned and he left. He left in a state of anger. And he thought that Allah Azza wa Jalla was not going to punish him because of the calamities that had befallen him. He thought that nobody's listened to me, nobody's answered me. Allah will not punish me if I just turn around and leave. And we know the story that he got on a boat, and the boat hit rough seas, and they needed to throw some people overboard. So they drew lots about which person they would throw overboard, and every time it became Dhunnun, Yunus alayhi salam, that was going to be thrown off the ship. They didn't want to throw him off because they recognized his piety, and they thought that he is surely going to be the one that is going to bring us the mercy of Allah, and the barakah from him we'll get to safety. But after repeating it, they realized that there was no one else, that it kept on coming out as being Yunus. So they threw him overboard, and he was swallowed by the whale. I mean, imagine being thrown off a ship to drown in the sea, and then being swallowed by a large fish or a whale. And then he's alive in the belly of the whale. And the insides of the whale begin to eat at his skin. The enzymes in the stomach of the whale, they begin to eat at his skin. And when he's in this terrible situation, he realizes the reason he's there is because he made a mistake. He did a sin. He left before Allah Azza wa Jal gave him permission. It doesn't matter that nobody accepted his da'wah, but Allah hadn't given him permission. And Allah Azza wa Jal wants to raise his prophets and his messengers upon that high standard of iman and obedience to Allah Azza wa Jal, even though he didn't realize the implication of his actions. That's why Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَظَنَّ أَن لَن نَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ. He thought that we weren't going to punish him for what he did. And then he called out, فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ, with such a beautiful dua. He called out the greatest words of dua. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. Subhanallah is to say that Allah Azza wa Jal is perfect and we are imperfect. Glory be to Allah who is perfect when we are imperfect. And then he admits that he's been an oppressive person. He hasn't done the right thing. He's oppressed himself. Not the oppression of shirk, not the oppression towards fellow human beings, but he's oppressed himself with sin, as we all do. La ilaha illa anta subhanak inni kuntu min al-zalimin. What did Allah Azza wa Jal answer him to this dua? Whatever situation you're in, whatever difficulty you're in, however bad things have got, however far away you are from practicing Islam, open up the Mus'haf. Ayah number 87 from the 21st surah in the Quran, Suratul Anbiya. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. What does Allah Azza wa Jalla say? Fastajabna lah. We answered him. Wa najjaynahu min al-gham. And we took him away from the distress that he was in. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, wa kadhalika nunji al-mu'minin. In this way, with this dua, we will save every believer who does the same as he did. A promise from Allah. Fastajabna lah. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْغَمِّ وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jal promises you He will deliver you from your stress and your distress and your problems with this dua. وَزَكَرِيَّا إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ. Zachariah, when he called upon his Lord and he said, "Oh my Lord, don't leave me without any offspring, childless, fardan, wa anta khayrul warithin, and you are the best of inheritors. I don't leave anything better than to leave what I leave for your sake. There's no one better to guard my family and to guard my ummah than you, O Allah, whether I'm alive or dead. But don't leave me without a child." How many of us have problems? There will be people watching this, brothers and sisters who are trying to have children, they can't have children. What dua do you have better than this dua? Than all of these duas, Ayyub and Yunus and Zakariya. Rabbi la tadharni fardan. Oh Allah, don't leave me without a child. Don't leave me childless. Wa anta khayrul warithin. What does Allah Azza wa Jalla say? Fastajabna lah. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. We answered his dua. وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ يَحْيَى وَأَصْلَحْنَا لَهُ زَوْجَهُ. Not only did we give him Yahya, but we made his wife right again. And this suggests that the problem was that his wife wasn't able to have children. She had a problem, and it's mentioned in other ayat in the Quran, perhaps from old age, because he was old and his wife were old. And through old age or illness or whatever problem, she wasn't able to have children. So Allah Azza wa Jal corrected the problem that was with her. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purified whatever issue was there with her. Whatever the doctor says to you, when the doctor says you can't have children, raise your hands and say, رَبِّ لَا تَذَرْنِي فَرْدًا وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الْوَارِثِينَ. Along with the istighfar that is mentioned in Surah Nuh, that we mentioned in the previous episodes about the explanation of Surah Nuh. Seek forgiveness from Allah and make this dua. Allah Azza wa Jal can correct any situation. He can give boys to whoever He wants, girls to whoever He wants, and He leaves whoever He wants childless. And if Allah Azza wa Jal leaves you childless, don't think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala won't give you the reward of children on the Day of Judgment for your intention and for your dua. And then Allah Azza wa Jal mentions something very important, brothers and sisters. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ. Why was their dua answered? They used to rush to do good deeds. They used to call upon Allah in fear and hope, and they used to be humble and submissive and attentive before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you're finding these duas are not being accepted, look at these three things. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ. Rush to do good deeds. Call upon Allah in fear and hope. And we've mentioned this in a previous episode. And be submissive and attentive in your prayer, in your dua, in your dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah Azza wa Jal mentions Maryam alayhi salam, the one who, when she was chaste, she kept onto her dignity and she protected herself and her private parts from haram. Allah Azza wa Jal blessed her with Isa alayhi salam and made both Isa and Maryam a sign for all of the worlds, because she gave birth without a father. And Isa spoke in the cradle alayhim as-salatu was-salam. And then Allah Azza wa Jal mentions, and we'll conclude with this, Inna hadhihi ummatukum ummatan wahida وَأَنَا رَبُّكُمْ فَعْبُدُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jal calls to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and says, this is your ummah. These are the people that you, whose lineage you came from, who you followed as a prophet. These prophets that have been mentioned in Surah Al-Anbiya. This is your religion, Islamic monotheism. Islam is your religion. Islam was the religion of Ayyub. Islam was the religion of Yunus, Islam was the religion of Zakariya, Islam was the religion of Maryam and Isa alayhimu salatu wassalam. This is your ummah, and I am your Lord, so worship me alone. Allah Azza wa Jal says to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is your ummah, one religion, and I am your Lord, so worship me. And with that, we'll conclude this episode. Until next time, inshaAllah ta'ala, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.